Looking critically into this supplementary schedule, lots of money has been earmarked to purchase cars for ministers. Among beneficiaries from the car bonanza is Minister of East African Community Affairs that is seeking shillings 1.2 billion to procure 3 vehicles for the first Deputy Prime Minister as well as Minister of East African Community Affairs, the former Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga.
Supplementary request we are making conforms to the compliance requirements of unforeseen and unavoidable. And Mr. Chairman, I wish to put it on record that every item that is included in this schedule was subjected to this criteria and they all qualify.
The Office of the President is seeking for an additional 8.31 billion for motor vehicles for presidential advisors and other officials, while the same vote want 550 million to purchase a station wagon for Minister of State for Economic Monitoring, Peter Gwang.
Office of the President, 20.609 billion was provided as follows. 11.513 billion was provided towards meeting the requirements of the presidential advisors, of which 3.2 billion is for salaries and 8.313 billion is for motor vehicles.
The Minister of Health is seeking for 1.225 billion to facilitate procurement of 2 motor vehicles for new ministers and an additional 9.466 billion to pay taxes on 282 double cabin motor vehicles procured for COVID emergency response, while the Minister of Public Service is seeking 720 million shillings to purchase motor vehicles of 3,500 to 4,000 cc for former Vice President at 370 million.
It is unfortunate that our ministers are so greedy. First and foremost, these ministers succeeded other ministers that actually had good vehicles. And some of these good vehicles have not been basically pushed off. And therefore, they can be utilized by them.
I would recommend strongly frugality in government expenditures. As you know, our domestic tax revenue cannot meet our recurrent expenditures.
The Minister of Trade, Industry and Cooperatives also wants a cake of the car bonanza of 2.8 billion motor vehicles for new ministers as well as the permanent secretary, while the Office of the President needs an addition of 550 million to purchase new wheels for the Minister of Ethics and Integrity.
When it is the time for members of parliament to get just 200,000 to buy all the cars, everybody is up in the arms. And they are complaining and they are saying that the parliament is expensive. They want a lot of money. How come then now we are talking of getting 27 billion shillings to buy cars just only for ministers?
When we talk about bad expenditure, the public must be interested. But the government itself must get ashamed of these expenses at such a time.
The meaning of a supplementary budget, the meaning has become fake. It is like people plan and then they know that we are going to request for more money. If anything, some ministries are asking for money beyond their original budget. And that shows to us that there is a lot of corruption.
The Minister of Foreign Affairs is also not late for the bonanza with a request of 500 million shillings to buy a vehicle for Minister of State for Foreign Affairs Regional Cooperation, John Mulimba. Surprisingly, the cost of vehicles as budgeted by different ministries varies, yet they have the same make.
If it is on average that government cars should cost 500,000 or 600,000, that should be the rate. That should be, you know, across board.
Within the next 5 years, is that there will be strong consideration, either through a private member's bill, to come up with the vehicles policy for public servants.
The Internal Security Organization is also seeking 18 billion, which will go towards classified expenditure. As part of that amount, which will go towards purchase of cars, but the security body hasn't given a breakdown of how much will be spent on cars. It's also important to note that every minister recently received 200 million taxpayers' money from Parliament to buy themselves vehicles. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.